Your place.
And you open the door for me, and you lay down your life to set me free. All that I am will serve you,
Lord. The Holy Ghost said to tell you, I the Lord shall introduce you. Luke chapter 11, everyone will read verse 6. One to go. For a friend of mine in his journey is come to me, and I have nothing to set before him. This morning, I preach on what I titled Freedom from Embarrassments. I wish your amen is the loudest, your miracle will be the biggest. Traveling, and when he was traveling, he passed through my house and came to visit me in his journey. Why did he come? He came because he knew I used to be very rich. Or you don't believe that was a rich man, I'll tell you now. Do you know that when he was going to his other friend to ask for money, that friend was a rich man. His number two qualities, he said, have my children with me on bed. Number two quality, he says, the man had bread to give him. And he had a door that has a fence gate. No poor man is so close to a rich man. So the two of them, to even wake him up. So the two of them were on as at 3 years ago. I want to paint a picture of this man whom the devil has now reduced to a beggar of bread. I want you to look at this man. A man who was so rich that his other friend, who has not seen him for some years, in his journey, he thought of not stopping by a hotel, but stopping by him, not knowing that by the time he stopped by him, things are so rough. Anyone hearing my voice, that witches have brought down your finances, that witches have brought down your favor, if you jump and say amen, today is your promotion. Today is your promotion. Today is your promotion. Today is freedom from embarrassment. Freedom from embarrassment. I know you don't understand. My brother, my sister, it is an embarrassment that a visitor in your house does not have even bread to eat. Don't worry, you understand. Let me finish preaching. Don't worry. It is an embarrassment that your children are in the house and school has started and they don't have school fees. I have been there. It is an embarrassment for house rent to be due and you are not ready to pay it. It is an embarrassment that you check your pockets and there is no offering to give. Oh my God, if I am called of God, you shall be delivered from that embarrassment. You shall be delivered from that embarrassment. I deliver you and your family from the embarrassment of poverty, from the embarrassment of sickness, from the embarrassment of poverty. Everything that's embarrassed you, I set you free today. I set you free today. Somebody say, yeah. A friend of mine has come. Better. I don't even have bread to set before my visitors. And he came with his wife and children. And they knew me that I'm a generous man. They knew me that I'm a rich man. I live in a big house. I've given them one room to stay. But the problem is breakfast. La problème c'est petit déjeuner. Oui. I don't have common breakfast. You don't know how it feels when a man cannot fuel his car. You don't know how it feels when a man cannot foot his bills. You don't have an idea when a woman passes by a shop and sees a dress that she has been looking for, a dress that she likes. She's not Ghana, she just wants to wear good things. And she looks at this dress, she asks how much, they say 15,000 naira. And she shakes her head and tears are coming on her eyes because she does not have that amount, but she desires good things. There are people hearing my voice today. Your stories are turned around today. Your stories are turned around today. Your stories are turned around today. Lift your voice, say amen. They came to see me. And what's supposed to be a celebration of a visitation has become an embarrassment. May your children not be sick of malaria when you cannot buy medicine. May your first son not have admission when you cannot pay school fees. May your wife not be ready to go to market when there's no money in your pockets. Lord, help me this morning. Holy Spirit, I need your grace so that everyone that say amen shall go back jubilating, shall go back celebrating, shall go back testifying. God shall put a testimony in your mouth today. God shall put a new song in your mouth today. Your pocket shall be full. Your bank account shall be full. Your wardrobe shall be full. Your kitchen shall be full. There shall be no more embarrassment. A friend of mine has come. Look at the time the friend has come. Do you know the time the friend came? Midnight. Read the whole Bible. Unexpected, unbudgeted expenditure is a source of embarrassment. If you stamp your feet on the ground and point your hand to the altar, you shall not be embarrassed. You shall not be embarrassed. You shall not be embarrassed. Burial shall not embarrass you. School fees shall not embarrass you. House rent shall not embarrass you. Landlord shall not embarrass you. Sickness shall not embarrass you. Police shall not embarrass you. Tenant shall not embarrass you. Shout them and free touch. alone in the house and you have no visitor, you and your wife and children, can I tell you a secret? You can survive. I've survived before now. You miss Gary Ubonga fish. You know sleep? They are quiet. They are quiet. You take beans, put inside bread, fold the bread together, and dip in oil, palm oil. Somebody make a joyful noise! You grab groundnut, put inside the mouth, open Coca-Cola, no tumbler, no glass. Tuku, 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 tuku. Inodu, inodu. In the morning, fry yam. In the afternoon, boil yam. In the evening, pounded yam. In no sleep, in no chop. But when somebody arrives, with his house girl, his junior brothers, and his three children, and his fat wife. They don't arrive in the morning. They don't arrive in the noon. In the evening, they don't arrive. They arrive at midnight. My Bible says, the man began to go around the streets. How many of you have scrolled your phone before? You don't know who to call. Let me see your hand. See, you are pretending. How many have scrolled phone? You are in trouble. You roll your phone. You are like, who can I talk to and he will not laugh? Who can I ask and he will not disgrace me? Who can I confide in? Who will understand what I'm going through? Who will not say to me, you are careless, you are lazy? Oh God, how many of you have had that situation? If you have had that situation, I came to prophesy to you, this is the end of embarrassment. This is the end of shame. This is the end of begging for food. Can you shout the biggest amen? There are a lot of rich men in your phone, but rich women, but who will not laugh? Who will not say, now only fine, fine clothes they wear? Looking for 15,000. Who will not say, I'm tired of him? Can you feel this message? Who will not say, I be worth the salary college way keeper? Who will not use my weakness against me? Who will not tell the story to another neighbor? Whom will I confide in? Whom can I trust? That's why we're singing Psalm 25 this morning, verse 1 and 2. Unto thee, O Lord, do I lift up my soul. Oh my God, I trust in you. Don't let me be ashamed. And don't let my enemies to triumph over me. As I kneel on this altar, your enemies shall not triumph over you. Your enemies shall not triumph over you. You shall not be disgraced. It is your year of glory and honor. It is not your year of shame and embarrassment. It's your year of extra. For a friend of mine in his journey, he's come to me and I have nothing to say before him. Look at verse 7. Somebody help me read verse 7.
And he from within,
and the holy sir, and the man who was inside
shall answer and say,
he answered,
Trouble me not.
Don't call my phone again.
The door is now shut.
Do you know what I pray sometimes? God, give me, I will give to people. Don't let me ask people. Please, Lord, please. Okay, do like, give me, I will give. But don't make me go and ask. I don't know. I find it comfortable to give to people. But people don't find it comfortable to give to me. I share when I have. But when they have, they run. They're off their phone. You've been there, sir. God, give me, I will give. Don't give people for me to pray for them to give me. My daughter, do you understand? Sir, do you understand? God, give me. Let God give me. If he gives me, okay, I will give. God, give me, I will distribute. Don't let me go to ask. The Bible says, he that was inside, what did he say? Don't trouble me. Can I give you a prophecy? Do you believe I'm a man of God? Everyone that thought you troubled them, they shall see your glory before the end of the year. They shall see your glory. They shall see your blessings. They shall see your prosperity. Can you say amen? Tell your neighbor, don't worry. I will not trouble you again. I have my own. Can you shout the biggest amen? And he said, for the door is now shut. Can I prophesy to you? Oh. Every businessman and woman whose door was shut, I open the door. I open your 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 door. Can you shout it? Sir, ma, why are you begging? Because your door is shut. Somebody has shut the door against your promotion in the office. Hear me today. Something will happen here today. Somebody has shut a door over your face. But I come as a prophet of God. If God has laid his hands on me, every closed door, open, open, open. Shout the louder, amen. Lift your hands and say, oh God, every closed door against my life, against my finances, is open right now. Hit your feet and shout amen. For the door is shut, and my children?
And my children are with me in bed.
Can I say something? You laugh. What is more important to people is very funny. Look at the two problems. What is my problem? I have visitors. They have arrived from far place, and I don't have food for them to eat. Those days, people travel not by flight, they travel by desert, 3 days. They have arrived in my house. They have not eaten. And you are telling me your problem. What is your problem? One, the door is closed. Two, the children are sleeping. Please wait, let me try and understand. Your children are sleeping, which means you are not sleeping. Because you are answering me. I don't need children to give me bread. You. Yam bread. And you are giving. Can you listen to that excuse? My door is closed. You have the key. Every door that's closed in the night, the key is inside. And the Bible says, he that was inside. Number two, my children
are with me in bed.
Wait, wait. If 10 of us die, it does not matter to you. What matters to you is that your children's sleep should not be disturbed. Every one of you hearing my message, if you want to make heaven, stop being selfish. I rebuke selfishness in your life. After this message, release some money, release clothes, distribute to the necessity of the saints. Let liberty flow. Let people around you feel it. What a stupid excuse that your children are sleeping. Your children are sleeping because they have eaten. If they have not eaten, they will not sleep. And a child that says that the mother cannot sleep, that child also cannot sleep. When you are the only one in your house that eat and eat and eat, others don't eat, they will wake you up. That is a scripture. But today, everyone hearing my voice, God is about to empower you with wealth. Wealth for your family, wealth for your village, wealth for your generation, wealth for your nation, wealth for your friends. Lift your right hand and pray for 1 minute. And say, Father, I shall not beg for bread. Take your seat and clap for Jesus. Psalm 37 verse 25. You don't need to open. Psalm 37 verse 25. It says, since I was young and now I am old, I have never seen the righteous man forsaken, nor his seed begging for bread. Can I prophesy? If you clap, I shall prophesy. Your children shall not beg for food. Your family shall not beg for clothes. Your village shall not beg for projects. You are the answer to their prayers. Receive prosperity. Receive deliverance. Receive help from above. Since I was young, now I'm old. I've never seen. I love Psalm 128. I love Psalm 128 very much. It's one of my favorite psalms. It says in verse 1, blessed are those who fear the Lord and who walk in his ways. And it says in verse 2, it says, they happy are they, and it shall be well with them, for they shall eat the fruit of their labor. And it says in verse 3, it says, even their wife shall be like fruitful vine by the side of their house. And it says, even their children shall be like olive plants round about their table. So shall a man who fears the Lord be blessed. I bless you this morning. Those of you sitting upstairs, jump up. All of you sitting up there, jump up and say, I am blessed. Yes. All of you that are expecting a miracle before the end of the year, jump up and say, I am blessed. Five things that will happen to a righteous man. Five things that will happen to a Christian. Psalm 128 that we read. He said he will eat the labor of his hands. That's number one. Number two, he says, happy he shall be on earth. And number three, he says, it shall be well with him. And number four, he said, even the wife he married shall be like a fruitful vine by the side of his house. And number five, he said, his own children shall be like olive plant round about his table. What is the meaning of olive plant round about the table? Children never lacking what to eat on the table. Point your right hand to me. Say, oh God, I receive freedom from embarrassment. Can you shout the loudest amen? Let me give you four or five examples of embarrassment in the scriptures and how God delivered them. Four or five examples of embarrassment in the scriptures and how God delivered them. Matthew chapter 17 verse 27. Matthew 17 verse 27. Jesus was embarrassed to be embarrassed by tax collectors. Matthew 17 verse 27. They came to him. They knew that Jesus has finished a crusade. He doesn't have money. They said to Peter, does your master pay tax? You know, the worst poverty is not the one they tell you you are poor. It's the one they tell your children your father is poor. The poverty they tell you are poor, you can answer. You can tell them what you used to have. You can boast. You can tell them how many degrees you have. You can mention that you have lived in a good house. It doesn't affect you. But the one they tell your children. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, today, shout it. Neighbor, today is freedom from embarrassment. Does your master pay tax? You know what Jesus said in verse 27? I'll tell you. He said, notwithstanding, lest we should offend them, take thy hook and go to the sea, and the first fish that cometh, bring it out and open the mouth. Thou shalt see money. Take it and pay for me and for thee. Oh my God. How many of you believe that after you jump and say amen, money is coming? Money is coming to you. 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 Lift your voice and say, yeah! Take it and pay for me and for you. Hear me. Every money you have is for him and for you. For him, tithes, prophecies, pledges, offering. For you, houses, good cars, fine education, and good life. For you and for me. Let me tell you another embarrassment in the Bible. Another embarrassment in the Bible is 2 Kings chapter 6 verse 5. 2 Kings chapter 6 verse 5. The sons of the prophet went out with Elisha to expand their coast. My Bible says the ass head fell into the water and the boy shouted, "Alas, master, for it was borrowed." How many of you know that the greatest shame in your life is to borrow? Deuteronomy chapter 28, Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 12, "And thou shalt lend to many nations, and thou shalt not borrow." As I'm speaking today, I carry grace. I carry grace. If somebody's owing you, or you are owing somebody, that matter shall be settled after your amen. Shall be settled after your amen. Shall be settled after your amen. Say after me, "I shall lend to many nations, I shall not borrow." But my Bible says Elisha did something and the iron head floated. Point to me, say, "Man of God, do something." Point to heaven, say, "Holy Ghost, pass through yourself and do something." Lay the hand on your chest, say, "I receive it." Do you know how embarrassing to borrow an axe head? Okay, sit down. I know why you don't understand. Sit down. Okay, sit down. I know. We don't borrow axe head again. We now borrow machines. We now borrow cars. It's painful. The Bible says for the creditor, for the debtor, is a servant to the creditor. 2 Kings chapter 4 verse 1. 2 Kings chapter 4 verse 1. "And they came one of the wives of the son of the prophet to Elisha and said, 'Thy servant, my husband, is dead. And now the creditor is come to take my two sons to be born men.'" Oh, anyone that is in trouble today, anyone that has been disgraced, anyone your landlord is looking for, anyone the job is not being given, anyone that is struggling to pay school fees, if you shout the biggest amen, my God shall surprise you. My God shall surprise you. Philippians chapter 4 verse 19. Philippians 4 verse 19. "For my God shall supply all your need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus." Philippians chapter 4 verse 6. "Be anxious for nothing, but with thanksgiving, with praise in your heart, let your requests be made known unto God." You shall not be embarrassed. Let me give you one prophecy before I pray. Every one of you that embarrassment is waiting for, every one of you that shame is waiting for, as you shout amen, it shall not come to you. Are you ready for the last one? I want to pray for you a prayer of open door. That gate that is locked shall be opened. The Bible said the friend did not want to open, but because of his importunity, Let me tell some of you, you need perseverance and importunity today. You need faith today. It is faith that shall open the doors that your enemies have locked against your promotion and your prosperity. It is faith and perseverance and importunity that will break the yoke, that will lift up the gates that has been locked against your bread, locked against your blessing, locked against your promotion, locked against your marriage. Today, I have come as a prophet to open that gate, to open that door, to open that gate, to open that door. Can you shout the loudest amen? John chapter 2. Verse 3. Very interesting. Hear this. Don't worry, I will read for you. I will read for you, don't worry. And when they wanted wine, the mother of Jesus said unto him, they have no wine. Let me tell you what shocked me. What shocked me is that Satan is wicked. Do you notice that that wine did not finish when they didn't want wine? When they wanted wine, that's when the wine finished. The devil is a liar. He wants to disgrace you at the moment of your honor. At the time of your celebration, he wants to mess up your testimony. But I have come. I say I have come. In the name of the Lord God, you shall not see shame. But hear me. Anytime you need something and God wants to give you something, he will tell you, bring. I did a research. I saw about 500 scriptures that anytime God wants to release a blessing, he will tell the person, bring. When the ass head fell into the water, Elisha said, bring. Bring what? You have forgotten. Bring a stick. When the widow was gathering stick to eat her last food and die, Elijah said to the widow, bring me water to eat, to drink, bring me food to eat. When Abraham was to be alone and die with that promise, God said to him, bring me your only son. In 2 Kings chapter 4, that we read about the widow, she said that the creditors come. Elisha said, what shall I do? Two questions. One, what shall I do for you? And two, what do you have? In every miracle that happened, it comes from two. One, what I can do. And two, what you have. If what I can do, which is the grace I carry, is released by what you have, and both of them meet, my brother, no Satan can stop it. No miracle happened until these two things meet. 2 Kings 4 verse 2. One, what can I do? Two, what do you have? The people have misunderstood. Elisha said, woman, your husband is dead. Tomorrow, the creditors are coming. The only two things, what can I do? I have anointing, I have grace, but what do you have? Stand on your feet, everybody. Pray for 2 minutes. I challenge those of you that will shout amen, that your story will change. For a friend of mine in his journey came to me and I have nothing to present before them. This is the end of nothing in your family. This is the end of nothing in your bank account. This is the end. Pray for 1 minute. Pray for 1 minute. Pray for 1 minute. Pray for 1 minute. Unto thee, O Lord.
Soul.
Unto thee, O Lord. Come on.
Unto thee, O Lord.
Will I lift up my soul?
Will I lift up my soul?
Oh
my God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
My God.
I trust
in
to pray three kinds of prayer points today. I'm not here to impress you. I'm here to impress the one who sent me. And the first prayer point is all those who are going to face embarrassment, who are going to face disciplinary action, who are going to face shame. You sense in your spirit you have been set up to be embarrassed. There's a disaster coming. There's a shame about to come. Can you run to the altar? You sense in your spirit somebody's challenging you, your landlord, somebody you owed money, somebody you promised something. Lift your hands as you pray. Lift your hands up. Lift your hands up. Lift it up. Lift your hands up. Lift your hands up. Unto thee, O Lord. Lift up my soul.
Do I lift up my soul?
Unto thee, O Lord.
Unto thee, O Lord.
Do I lift up my soul? Anybody was planning embarrassment, was planning sickness, was planning poverty, was planning divorce, was planning arrests or court case. Anywhere the devil has ambushed any of your children here to make them to be disgraced, to expose them and to destroy them. Father, I stand in the gap as a prophet of the Most High God. But if I am your servant and you call me and anointed me, vindicate me, O God. Rise on my behalf. Do the impossible. Answer their prayers. Wipe away tears. Let miracles happen. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
To the hopeless and light, to those in the darkness and death, to life. Now I'm alive. Oh, you give peace to the restless. I see.